So this is second group with the topic of quantum computing. So please, you may start your presentation. Entanglement.
Quantum computers use qubits instead of traditional bits in binary digits. Qubits are different from traditional bits because until they are read out in the medium, they can exist in an intermediate state where we can tell whether they are measured as a 0 or a 1. That's because of a unique property called superposition. Superposition makes qubit interesting, but the real superpower is entanglement. Entangled qubit can interact instantly, make functional qubits. So, masih dekat interaksi
qubits. Saya confused. Saya confused. Okay. So, please proceed, sorry.
To make functional qubits, quantum computers have to be full to near absolute zero. Even when super cool, qubits then maintain their entangled state coherence for very long. For the architecture of quantum computer, I would like to pass the file to my groups.
Okay, thank you. Next.
Quantum measurement of back to the above classical layer for merging the quantum outcome to the binary layer. For the next layer is analog layer. It creates voltage signal which having a phase and amplitude modulation like in wave for sending it to the below layer so that the qubit operation can be executed. For next layer is quantum layer. It is integrated with the digital and the analog processing layer onto the same chip. It is used for holding qubit and it kept at room temperature. Error correction is handled here. This layer determines how well the computer performs. For the next slide, I will use to
okay, thank you.
So I'm going to say is quantum
lag ah, kenapa eh? Hello, you line awak slow eh, macam lag.
Sekejap saya.
Hello.
Oh, member-member awak semua okey je. Lain awak slow ke apa?
Yes.
Macam sangkut-sangkut. Boleh? Ah, dah okey, dah okey. Try, try. How it works. Try dulu.
Hello, hello.
Ah, okey. Please proceed.
Okay. So, how quantum computers works are that quantum and classical computers both try to solve problems. But the way they manipulate data to get answers is fundamentally different. This section provides an explanation of what makes quantum computers unique by introducing two principles of quantum mechanics crucial for their operation, superposition and entanglement. So, apa yang dia explain sini adalah quantum adalah cara yang baru, cara baru yang untuk mendapat satu data. Classical computers adalah sistem yang kita digunakan pakai sekarang. Contohnya macam laptop kita sekarang.
Okay.
Sudah menyelesaikan satu masalah untuk mendapatkan satu data, tapi cara dia orang dapat data tu adalah berbeza.
Okay, good.
Superposition is the counterintuitive ability of a quantum object like an electron. So, to simultaneously exist in multiple states. For an example that a penny is not either head or tails instead, which in combination head or tails. So, apa yang maksud di sini adalah dalam superposition quantum dia mengira bit juga macam classical computers. Cuma dalam classical computers tu sebagai contoh adalah duit shilling. Shilling ada kepala dengan ekor. Contohnya kepala tu satu, ekor tu kosong. So dalam bit tu kan ada 1001 apa semua tu kan, dalam logic gate nak kira apa semua tu. Tapi kalau dengan konsep superposition ni dia boleh, satu dengan kosong tu dia boleh wujud pada masa yang, kalau yang classical computers tu dia boleh wujud pada, kalau dia head dia akan muncul satu bit lah, kalau yang echo tu dia akan jadi kosong. So dia superposition ni function dia adalah untuk bagi efficiency lah, untuk mengira satu bit tu. For entanglement is a phenomenon in which quantum entities are created and manipulated such that none of them can be described without referencing the others. For example, two things are connected in some way and usually can separate them. Dia macam konsep superposition tadi. Bit satu dengan kosong tu boleh wujud pada waktu yang sama. The way quantum computers leverage probabilities and entanglement is what makes them so different from classical computers. So for the next slide, my friend will continue.
Hello, assalamualaikum. My name is Muhammad Raimi Muhammad Afizal. I will present about the application of quantum computing. So the first one is a computational chemistry. The computational chemistry is it is believed that the number of quantum state, even if the tininess of a molecule is extremely vast and therefore difficult for conventional computing memory purposes. For the second one is drug design and development. This is full enhance efficiency dramatically by allowing companies to carry out more drug discovery to uncover new medical treatment for the better pharmaceutical industry. And the next is cybersecurity and cryptography. So the this for developing various techniques to combat cybersecurity threat and help creating encryption method, also known as quantum cryptography. Okay.
Okay.
Next is a relation quantum computing to IoT. So the first one is a optimized complex computation power. So this for with quantum computing, the speed is incredibly high. IoT benefit from this speed since IoT device generate a massive amount of data that requires heavy computation and other complex optimization. For the second is a faster validation and verification process. So the quantum computing addresses that concern as it can speed up the verification and validation process across all the system several times faster while ensuring constant optimization of the system. For the last is a more secure communication. A more secure communication is possible through quantum cryptography. As explained before, the complexities serve as a defense against cyber attack, including data breaches, authentication and malware and ransomware. So the next I would like to pass to our friend.
So for the conclusion of quantum computers is that quantum computers have the potential to revolutionize computation by making certain types of classically intractable problems solvable. While no quantum computers is yet sophisticated enough to carry out calculations that a classical computer can, a great progress is underway. So maknanya quantum computers ni dia ada potensi untuk mengubah dunia komputer dalam untuk menyelesaikan masalah-masalah yang klasifikasi komputer tak boleh menyelesaikan. Tapi komputer ni masih lagi tak boleh pakai lagi, diguna pakai lagi, sebab apa yang klasifikasi komputer yang ada sekarang ni, calculation dia boleh buat semua apa yang quantum computers buat. So with the capabilities of quantum computing can help address the challenges and issues that hamper the growth of IoT. The technology of quantum computing is very promising. Continuous research and development are expected until such time that there is widespread practical applications for both consumers and businesses. That's all for our group. This is the end of the slide. Thank you very much for listening.
Okay, thank you, Group 2, on your presentation of quantum computing. So, saya nak tambah sikit lagi, a little bit in these topics, because quantum computing ni essentially a new technique or a new technology in computing. So, kalau awak tengok balik in your presentation, dia akan compare quantum and classical computers. So, classical computers yang kita ada sekarang lah. Even your phone pun, tu dia kira komputer lah. So, kalau you tengok, you punya phone tu dah canggih dah kan. You boleh buat banyak kerja, many works yang can be done even from your computers. Tapi, quantum computing ni teknologi baru yang sekiranya berjaya dikembangkan, dia lebih multiple times better from the classical computers. But kalau tengok sekarang ni quantum computers, dia tengok ada gambar kat atas kan, yang sebelah kiri yang atas tu, itu quantum computers. Itu bukan, it's not actually quantum computer tu yang kat atas tu, itu a part of, itu dia punya cooling system dia. Okay, quantum computer dia kecil, cooling dia besar gila, almost sebesar almari. Dia punya cooling sahaja. Cooling sahaja dah sebesar almari. Sebab dia menggunakan teknologi quantum. Maka dia punya hubber tu terlampau tinggi. So, cooling dia memang kena sangat tinggi lah. Okay. So, tapi ini baru masih lagi dalam research and development, R&D. So, kalau tengok pun komputer yang classical computer yang kita ada sekarang ni, kalau tengok sejarah, komputer yang pertama dicipta pun dia sebesar satu bilik. Sebesar bilik. Ha, kalau awak tengok bilik server tu ada banyak banyak rack kan. Awak boleh bayangkan dulu komputer yang pertama dulu, yang sebab kita belajar komputer interfacing kan. So komputer yang asal-asal dulu, komputer yang datuk nenek moyang dia dulu adalah sebesar satu bilik server tu. Sekarang ni dah boleh masuk poket kita kan. Phone boleh masuk dalam poket kita. Begitulah. Akan datang quantum computing pun macam tu. Akan datang satu masa nanti, quantum computing ni boleh masuk dalam poket kita. Okay. Why do I want you to explore this quantum computing? Sebab dia adalah teknologi baru. Okay. So, teknologi baru. So, bila you kerja nanti, maybe around 5 to 10 years, quantum computing ni akan boom lah. Maksudnya, orang akan banyak bercerita pasal quantum computing. Sekarang ni masih belum lagi. Sebab dia masih lagi dalam R&D. So, kalau 5 ke 10 tahun lagi you dah start guna quantum computing, at least you have an edge. Maksudnya you have awal lebih exposed lah compared to orang lain. So nampak macam apa benda lah quantum computing ni. Yes, this is new technology. Bila kita berbicara tentang new technology, you kena tahu lebih daripada orang lain lah, supaya nanti bila awak kerja atau awak, even kalau awak nak sambung belajar at least quantum computing ni, kalau you punya boss or you punya your lecturer tanya, pernah dengar quantum computing? Yes, pernah. Saya pernah research pasal a little bit on quantum computing. Lepas tu boleh cerita sikit tentang superposition, entanglement. Ada dua benda tu lah yang penting. Superposition and entanglement. So, superposition ni senang cerita macam ni. Kalau dalam dalam komputer, classical computer, dia gunakan electronic devices. So, electronic devices, dia gunakan elektron. Elektron kan, arus. Kalau awak belajar elektronik kan, dia guna arus. So, arus ni, elektron ni, it can be either one or zero. High atau low. State dia lah, state dia. State dia, high atau low. 5 volt atau 0 volt. dia adalah dia punya fluctuation, tapi dia tak boleh, dia tak boleh kira kalau kalau you belajar dia ada satu part yang undetermined state. Undetermined state tu maksudnya it cannot be either one or two. Dia mesti salah satu, one or zero. Tapi superposition ni maksud dia satu bit, qubit, dia panggil qubit lah. Untuk quantum computer dia panggil qubit. Satu bit tu it can be both satu dan kosong at the same time. Cuma satu dan kosong ni tu ada percentage lah. Maksudnya 50% satu, 50% kosong, ataupun 70% satu, 30% lagi zero. So dalam satu qubit tu boleh bawa data yang banyak. Okay, awak boleh bayangkan katakan satu data analog 10 bit. 10 bit tu boleh masuk dalam classical computer punya 10 bit boleh masuk dalam satu qubit. Sebenarnya lebih lah, tapi saya nak bagi penerangan. Kalau kan kalau kita buat projek gunakan ESP8266 tu, kan you dapat maksimum 1024. Kan kalau you pusing your potentiometer kan, 0 sampai 1024. So kenapa 1024? Sebab data dia in 10 bit. Okay, so kalau awak bayangkan 10 bit tu adalah 10 bit dalam classical computer. Tapi 10 bit tu, data 10 bit tu, you can push inside one qubit. Satu qubit boleh simpan, sebenarnya lebih lagi lah, tapi boleh simpan banyak data dalam satu qubit compared to normal bit in electronics, in electron lah, dalam arus tu. Okay, itu superposition. Entanglement ni, tu konsep dia lebih dalam lah, tapi secara general ya, entanglement, setiap qubit ni dia bersangkut paut dengan satu sama lain. Kalau awak pernah dengar blockchain pun teknik dia, bukan teknik lah, dia punya konsep dia lebih kurang sama, dia tak sama. Entanglement ni dia berkait antara satu sama lain qubit, tapi blockchain ni data tu yang berkait-kait. Data tu yang berkait antara chain lah, chain antara satu data ke satu data tu blockchain. Tapi entanglement ni dalam bentuk qubit. Okay, so it's a good way for exposure. So harapnya semua boleh expose lah dengan ni. Tak perlu you tahu detail sangat pun, you expose pun dah cukup of the quantum computing. Okay, so akan datang kita akan guna quantum computing, kita tak guna lagi elektron ni, elektrik pun kita tak guna dah lah dalam classical computer ni. Akan datang lah, saya bercerita pasal akan datang. Okay, masa tu you dah kerja, maybe you dah jadi boss of a company ke, ataupun you dah jadi top researcher ke, so you boleh research lah pasal ni. Okay, so thank you very much for second group, Mr. Ahmad Zikri, Azim, Raimi and Nick Amirul Fahmi. So thank you.